Hello, my name is Michele Romano, and I am one of the developers of the sales approach, the topic of this small presentation. Sales is an acronym, and it means Scientific Exercise Approach to Scoliosis. The word exercises and scoliosis are almost clear, and it means that sales is based on specific exercises for the non-surgical treatment of the spinal misalignment. The word scientific means based on evidence. We can use this word because we know that the sales is reliable to modify the natural history of scoliosis. We know this because we performed a series of trials published in the scientific literature. You can find this using PubMed. The word approach, it means that the sales is not a rigid method. Obviously, for the correct use of the sales, there is a series of rules, but they can be modified considering the specific characteristic of the patients. This adaptability is one of the features that most impress the people who discover the sales. The typical methods of exercises conceived for the conservative treatment of scoliosis patient and different from sales has strict rules and do not allow effective modification of what is proposed. Typically, choice of the specific exercises is linked to a classification of the curves. Consequently, the treatment is directly correlated with this. Obviously, the consequence is that the exercises to teach are the exercises that the developer of the method has indicated as appropriate for the specific curve identified by the classification. The sales approach is different. In this approach, the choice of the corrective action is not linked to the curve classification, but correlate to the specific feature of the specific patient. The core of the sales approach is an action named self-correction. This action is the search of the best possible alignment of the spine carried out without help. What is the helps? They can be external tools like the sticks, elastic bands, or specific position of the body like the all four position or lying position. It is clear that the best possible modification of the shape of the spine is possible using these helps. So the question is, why using the sales approach we don't ask the patient to use these helps? The reason is directly correlate with the final aim of the treatment. This aim is not the best possible realignment. I mean the more realigned movement. The aim is the more manageable realignment and the progressive integration of the correction in many daily life situation of the patient. And if I want to use the correction in the daily life, it's impossible the help of external tools or specific position of the body. This is a deep difference of concepts. How choose the self-correction? As I told you before, the choice of the self-correction is not linked to the curve classification, but correlate with the specific misalignment of the specific patient. During the first assessment, we took all the measure of all the misalignments of in all plans. Based on these measures, the physical therapist will decide the most important of these and start the teaching of the correction. The physical therapist will modify the self-correction, teaching a more difficult combination of more than one corrective movement to perform only when the ability of the patient will increase. This fundamental concept directly relates to a fundamental consequence. The correction of the cells must be a simple correction. This does not mean elementary correction, but correction adapted to the patient ability. Obviously, there are some rules to follow. These rules will become a big help for the choice of the cell correction. A very important difference between SEAS and other approaches is the concept of the exercise. In different methods of treatment based on specific exercises performed for the treatment of scoliosis patients and different from SEAS, the exercises are conceived as the effort to reach the self-correction using helps, and the stabilization of the self-correction is conceived as the effort to hold this more realigned position during some seconds. So, the exercise will be the self-correction performance and the holding of this. The basic purpose of the SES approach is the same of all the other methods. We want to increase the stability of the self-correction. Using the SES approach, this purpose is reached not only by the simple holding of the corrective posture, but by the training led by the progressive difficulties provoked by the exercises. Definitively, in the SES concept, the exercise is considered like a challenge. The SES organizes the combination of both therapeutic action. The first element is the performance of the self-correction. The second one will be the challenge of the self-correction holding using some dynamic action or unstable posture to put increases in self-correction and to train the muscles of the trunk to don't lose this position. So, in the SES approach, the self-correction and the exercises are two different but interlinked things. Never forget, when we speak about stability referring to the conservative scoliosis treatment, we don't talk about the stability of the spine. Otherwise, paradoxically, we speak about the scoliosis stabilization. With our exercises, we have to think about the stability of the correction. Until now, it is impossible to identify the specific muscles doing this action. With the exercise, we stimulate the involvement of all the muscles of the trunk who want to avoid the loss of the realignment achieved with the self-correction. Now I show you an example. This patient will perform a simple correction and an exercise to challenge this. After the assessment, the chosen self-correction was the derotation of the thoracolumbar portion of the spine in a clockwise direction. In the video, it will be difficult to observe this movement because it's a small movement. Then the patient will start to challenge the self-correction, performing a complex movement without losing the correction. After the execution of the exercise, the patient will relax the self-correction and you will magically appreciate again the left prominence of the curve. As you can see, the patient is in a standing position. She performed a clockwise derotation of the thoracolumbar spine. Then she performed this complex action without losing self-correction. Tilt of the trunk, bending of the knee, opening of the arms. Then she finished the exercise and she relaxed the self-correction. And voila, the prominence appear again. Dear friends, thank you very much for your attention. Ciao from Italy and see you soon.